Ridart provides two sets of certified overfill prevention valves indicated in our catalog as figures 442 and 442B. Both valves support the same function but differ in the actuating mechanism. We provide several models of overfill prevention valves, including the 3-inch and 4-inch valves with coated aluminum bodies, PTFE-coated aluminum bodies, and full stainless steel. The working principle is described as follows. The 442 overfill prevention valve line has two closing levels, depending on the turbulence and flow rate of the fluid. These values are indicated in the technical datasheet as the initial closing level for the maximum flow rate with high turbulence, and final closing level for lower flow rates. The 442 and 442B overfill prevention valves can ensure the complete closure of the intake. For this reason, the valve is subjected to the so-called hydraulic shock or fluid hammer. Both these valves, as well as many others of our overfill prevention valves, are tested and certified to handle this effect. For further information concerning the flow rate and maximum operating pressure, check our technical datasheet. There are different installation methods depending on the size, model, and various accessories available. Only a few possibilities are presented here. Many of the components shown in some configurations can also be used in other ways. The presented installation method applies to both the 3-inch overfill prevention valves. It consists of a pre-assembled module inserted into the fuel tank from the manhole lid and secured in place. The module is composed of an adapter collar connected with steel rivets to a pipe, which in turn is connected with the same configuration to the overfill prevention valve. Additional components may include an extension tube and a fuel diffuser. Alternatively, other adapters can be used. The pre-assembled module is inserted in a 4-inch pipe assembled on the manhole and through additional components installed, such as the 4-inch T connection. The whole module is designed to pass through without interference. The ring adapter sits on the 4-inch pipe without interfering with the thread. The module is then kept in place by a spacer screwed onto the T-valve. In order to regulate the installation height of the valve, the tubes can be shortened. During installation, make sure to use steel rivets for the top tube connection so that they can withstand the force due to the fluid hammering effect. The presented method allows for an easy and quick installation and maintenance without the need to disassemble the manhole lid. The 442B overfill prevention valve can still be mounted in the same way. Nevertheless, it is important during installation to properly direct the floater through the flange to avoid damage. Unlike the 442, the 442B requires some lateral space to work properly. During installation, make sure there is no component that can interfere with the valve. With the appropriate precautions, it is possible to disinstall the valve to carry out maintenance. In the present configuration, all components are fixed together in place on the flange. In this case, it's possible an easy installation if the flange can be detached without disassembling the whole manhole lid. The assembly in this case is composed of a coupler, according to the needs of the client, a 3-inch pipe, an anti-fraud grid fixed in the flange between two screwed connections, a variable length 3-inch pipe to adjust the height of the overfill prevention valve, and a drop tube with a collar adapter. Alternatively, we provide an equivalent 4-inch configuration with all components scaled, available only for the 442B overfill prevention valve. Alternative configurations may include a 4-inch loading duct with a reduction to a 3-inch overfill prevention valve. This configuration may be useful if a 3-inch flange is not present on the manhole or, alternatively, if the 4-inch flange hole is not wide enough to install the 4-inch overfill prevention valve.